Bringing innovation to your classroom with coding activities is not easy, especially if you have students with a certain disability, such as, for instance, blind or visually impaired students, or students with autism or Down syndrome. But doing this has many benefits for your students. Many children with disabilities usually struggle to develop their interpersonal and social skills, as well as other skills that can be practically applied in many aspects of day-to-day life. Bringing coding to the classroom can help to tackle this by helping students to learn how to solve problems, overcome failures and challenges, develop independence, and build also their self-esteem. In this video, we will show you how coding can be incorporated in any lesson and adapted for students with certain disabilities. A very easy and fun activity to start introducing coding to students with disabilities is, for instance, the egg carton unplugged. In this case, visually impaired students can learn coding without using any technology by creating their own algorithms, executing them and debugging their code if they make mistakes, all without even using a computer.
The objective of this activity is for students to make their own algorithms to collect all the egg prizes while avoiding traps like lava rocks. All you need to do a similar activity with your students are a few simple materials that you can easily find around your house or in your classroom, like egg cartons, plastic eggs, Lego pieces, and a small toy that will act as a robot, and felt paper. You can easily integrate this activity for primary students into a language lesson. For example, about storytelling, where students tell a story about their character or robot through algorithms. But also adapt this activity for lower or even higher secondary school students and students with other disabilities by simply adding a robot.
So let's see in practice how teachers can use technologies such as robots and 3D printers to facilitate learning. To do so, we have traveled here to Spain to two different schools where we will be hearing from students and teachers what the students have done in these activities and why they have enjoyed so much while working with these activities.
En la mayoría de los centros educativos hay alumnos con diferentes capacidades. Generalmente el profesorado tiene miedo porque nunca sabe qué tipo de actividades debería hacer o lo que sería mejor para ellos. En nuestros centros hemos trabajado con Iván, un estudiante con autismo, pero también con Esteban, un estudiante con síndrome de Down, y en ambos casos la codificación ha sido clave para el éxito de la actividad. En el caso de Iván, él se ha mostrado motivado, es un aprendizaje nuevo, pero muy intuitivo. Este tipo de niños suele ser muy meticuloso, y eso encaja a la perfección con este tipo de actividad. Para Esteban ha sido un entrenamiento, analizar una situación, programar una acción y ejecutarla, ver el resultado. Eso es lo que sucede en la propia vida cada vez que realizamos algo. Pero es un entrenamiento divertido porque él está con su grupo de compañeros y trabaja junto a ellos con un fin común, que en este caso es escribir un programa para un robot y alcanzar el objetivo marcado.
This project involves a group of children in which we have a child with Down syndrome, who is completely integrated. The students are divided into groups with three tutors, who work in different workspaces. The first activity's name is A Very Smart Mouse. In this activity, the students program a computer mouse to reach a cheese box. The second activity's name is Colby. In this activity, students program a robotic mouse to achieve the goals of the cars that they have. The third and last activity's name is We Meet. In this activity, two students are mice and the other two program them to reach the meeting point. After all the activities, the students can rate them with emoticons on a table.
But where is the role of the teacher when working with these activities, and how do students with learning disabilities such as autism spectrum or Down syndrome feel when working with technology, computational thinking or programming?
The teacher of technology will be responsible for organizing the activity in the classroom and also responsible for all the explanations. He will also be responsible for solving any kind of doubt that may arise in the class group. The students will work in pairs and they will have the help of a support teacher in case it is needed. They will also have a simplified instructions worksheet. As we have a student diagnosed with autism spectrum disorder, probably we will need the help of this support teacher. They will have to be able to draw the sketch of a Christmas star with the help of FreeCAD, and then, using Repeater Host, be able to print it in 3D. We have realized that with this kind of activities related to technology, also computational thinking and programming, this kind of students as Ivan, they feel better, they feel more secure, they are successful, and consequently they feel happier.
By introducing coding activities to students with certain disabilities, such as for instance autism or Down syndrome, your students will not only be learning coding, but they will also be developing their creativity, critical thinking and problem-solving skills, while at the same time having fun and being included into the classroom. But why students encourage teachers to bring coding activities to the classroom, even to students with disabilities? Listen to Ivan to find out.
Prefiero hacer unos proyectos porque así de esa forma trabajo con mis compañeros como con Aldara y desvelo mi imaginación y creatividad.
As you have seen so far, working with these kind of activities have many benefits, not only for students but also for teachers.
La actividad que realicé fue hacer una estrella fugaz en 3D, en una impresora 3D. El funcionamiento de la impresora. Me ha gustado trabajar en esta actividad porque he podido hacerla con mis compañeros. Sí, puede servirme bastante. Por si acaso nadie sabe cómo conectar la impresora 3D al programa, es algo bastante sencillo. Tocas el botón de conectar y ya.
Este tipo de actividad es muy recomendable a la hora de integrar alumnos con necesidades educativas, no solo porque ofrece un abanico muy grande de posibilidades de aprendizaje, sino porque lo hace de una manera transversal, mezclando distintas áreas como puede ser matemáticas, lengua, conocimiento del medio, conocimiento de uno mismo, pero de una manera muy natural y muy útil. No es un aprendizaje para almacenar, sino que hace a las personas más competentes para su vida. Por eso, todo profesor debería darle una oportunidad a este tipo de actividades dentro de su aula, no solo para el disfrute de sus alumnos, sino también para su propio goce.
Yo les diría que si acaso tuviesen tiempo, pudieran hacer la actividad. Y si tienen miedo, no pasa nada. Podéis intentar hacer la actividad. Si hace la actividad y fallan, que lo intenten otra vez. Y eso os lo digo a vosotros, profesores. Sí, y se le parece increíblástica. Si hiciera esta actividad, sería increíblástica.
Now that you know that coding activities can be easily integrated in the classroom, even though you have students with certain disabilities, have a look at the three lesson plans you will find out in the Code Week website for schools. Browse the website, choose one lesson plan and register the activity in the Code Week map.